got swag, we got swag. I got, you got, we got swag, we got swag. And we say with the, and we say with the, and we say with amazing grace. And we say with the, and we say with the, and we say with amazing grace. Say with amazing grace.
Oh, well, hello, swag, and hello, everyone. My name is Coach Camille, and I am so happy to be here with you today for your swag moment. So, kids, gather around, and even those who are young at heart, gather around, gather around. We usually do high fives, so high five, high five, high five, virtually to everyone. Oh, as you can see, I just finished a workout, so usually how I like to start my day, but how about you? How do you like to start your day? Do you start with school? And I bet it is so different now that school is at home and you have to stay at home. Your living room, maybe your classroom, or your bedroom, maybe not, or the kitchen. Oh, is kitchen a room? Oh, it could be, but it could be your classroom right now, just like my living room I made into a weight room for myself. And as you can see, I have my equipment here. I have more equipment here if I wanna go heavier and stronger. So that's what I wanna talk to you about today. I wanna talk to you about two words that sound the same, but are spelled differently. So what are those words called? Are they synonyms? Maybe they're antonyms. No, I don't think that's it. I think they're called homophones. Homophones are two words that sound the same, but are spelled differently, okay?
Let me give you a couple examples of homophones, like pear, there's two of these, or the fruit that you eat, that's a pear. Also, these are weights. This weight is a weight we use for our bodies, right? The heaviness in the weight and the tension that it builds in our muscles as we use it. Sometimes it can be very difficult, but it makes us stronger. And there's another kind of weight too, and that is W-A-I-T. And that weight means pause. It means hold on for a minute, stop for a moment. And you might've been told that by your parents sometimes. Maybe you wanted to play video games instead of doing your homework. They might've said, wait until after your homework. Or you might want a cookie, you know, before dinner. And they might say, wait until you finish your dinner. To wait, okay? And it's just like the Bible. In Psalms 27, verse 14, the Bible says, wait on the Lord, be of good courage, and he shall strengthen your heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. So, what does that mean for us today? That means if we wait in God and we put, so what does that mean for us today? That means if we wait in God and we put the heaviness and the pressure and the burden on the Lord who is strong and mighty, the Lord is strong enough to carry our weight. Yes, it's difficult right now. It's difficult not to see your friends at school, not to be able to go shopping or even go to the movies. But we are being strengthened as we wait. We are being strengthened from the inside so that when we come out of this and the wait is over, you're gonna be so overjoyed that you're gonna run to the school to learn and you're gonna love hanging out with your friends. You are going to be strengthened from the inside. So we are thankful for this wait period. So let us pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you so much for allowing us to wait on you and that you will carry our weight for us during this time. We pray, Heavenly Father, that we can be of good courage during this time and that you will continue to strengthen us as we go through this period. Please, Father God, look over our academics, our schoolwork, our classwork. Look over our families and protect them from any illness, harm, or danger. It is in your precious Son, Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. Thank you so much. Enjoy the rest of the service. And until next time, God bless you. Mm-hmm.